Good news, science discovered a virus that makes you dumber. Wait, that's bad news. Oh, I screwed up, don't roll the intro. Hey guys, I'm Joe, guest hosting for DNews. Scientists from the University of Nebraska, working in conjunction with scientists from Johns Hopkins Medical School, were getting their science on while studying the wonderful world of throat microbes when they accidentally stumbled upon a microorganism that they believe literally makes people, to put it delicately, stupid. The virus is known as Chlorovirus ATCV-1, and they discovered it inside the throats of 40 out of 92 volunteers. But before this study, science only found the stuff lurking in green algae, kicking it in freshwater lakes. Now, researchers have yet to figure out how Chlorovirus ATCV-1 migrates from our lakes and streams to the moist safe haven of human throats, if it migrates at all. They're not sure how it gets inside. But once it is, the microorganism is like that kid down the street that your parents didn't want you playing with because he had an affinity for the sound of breaking glass and the look of fire and was a straight up bad influence that made you more dumberer. After infiltrating and swabbing the throats of the 92 participants, the researchers proceeded to subject the volunteers to a number of cognitive tests, measuring attention span as well as speed and accuracy in visual processing. And lo and behold, the 44% carrying Chlorovirus ATCV-1 scored an average of 7 to 9 points lower on the tests, totally disappointing their overbearing parents in the process. I'm not dumb, Dad. My body is just home to a brain-altering microorganism that ravages my intelligence. Jeez! I'm out of here. I'm gonna go hang out with Ryan Jacoby. We're gonna throw rocks at windows and light a tree stump on fire. To double check the findings, the scientists did what scientists tend to do and experimented on unsuspecting mice, injecting a bunch of Stuart Littles with ATCV-1 and placed them in a mouse maze. And they got dumb. The stupid juice seeped into the hippocampus and scrambled memory formation and learning pathways, making it increasingly difficult for the mice to navigate the labyrinth and get accepted into Mouse Harvard. Now, this is super interesting for a number of reasons, but here's the thing. Our bodies are slathered inside and out with all sorts of microorganisms, and most are innocuous, but this study showcases that even though our immune systems may not be affected by a tiny intruder, our cognitive functions may still fall victim to their exploits. So the body stays strong while the mind secretly withers away. Dr. Robert Yolkin, co-author of the study, said, on average, people with the virus had perhaps a 5-10% decrease in the domains of brain function we measured. That's probably not noticeable in day-to-day conversation or activity, but is significant. It's kind of like Metachlorians from Star Wars that are inside the Jedi's, but instead of making you able to lift rocks with your mind, it just makes you scream at Rubik's Cubes. Taking things a step further, science will try to understand the subtle effects of all the tiny hitchhikers on our bodies, and will most certainly try to discover ways to alter the microorganism makeup inside us to make us not just healthier, but smarter as well. Cool. So do you think you have the stupid virus or know somebody who does? Tell us about it in the comments down below, and don't forget to subscribe for more DNews every day of the week.